we do not finally end like the process, but part of our approach will be to produce blueprints and other documentations or models that are highly accurate to make sure that our whole project is well thought out. And our analyses and RRP include building the Bluetooth and sensor subsystems, as well as their interfaces to make sure that those are connecting well and communicating, and then also build a small scale version of our steering system. And then once that has been finalized, then connected with the Bluetooth. And then for analyses, again, just analyze the structures and other electrical components.
All right. Space is for underdeveloped areas and off-grid situations. Many people lack access to conventional methods of logistics and for transportation. Doctors Without Borders conducted over 9.9 million outpatient consultations in 88 different countries in 2020. And each year, MSF teams walk millions of miles to provide health care. Our target market is for individuals who cannot carry heavy amounts of gear, such as people who are pregnant or disabled or injured. Organizations that are operating in rural areas, such as Doctors Without Borders, they get across rough terrain, and doing that with a bunch of gear can be dangerous for both the user, the person wearing the backpack, and the person that needs. Also, all outdoor enthusiasts want to bring gear and supplies on their excursions and welcome as well.
So this is our block diagram that outlines our whole system of the AMP car. And starting on the electrical side, we will have solar panels for our power source, solar power, and those would go to our charge controllers so we can safely charge the battery. So our device can operate smoothly and efficiently when it is not plugged in or not charging. The battery powers our motor and our processor, which is the brains of our device. And it does this through a DC or AC converter, depending on what we're designing for what our motor needs, and for what our processor will need.
Side of the block diagram, we start out with our frame. Frame would be the mechanical connection between the suspension system and the motor. The motor will then transfer the power to the gearbox, which will transfer the power to the rear gears and the thumb gears. The both rear and thumb gears will also be connected to the frame indirectly to the suspension system. Our steering will be controlled by a steering module that will be directly connected to the thumb gears. And our brakes will be controlled by a brake module, which will be mechanically connected to the rear wheels.
What we'll be doing for the computer side is the sensors will be annotating data from where the car is to the user's phone, and then from there, using that data and creating statements to kind of say where the car is compared to the user's phone, and how we control it. All of that is through a user interface, which will be an app on the smartphone.
And again, for our device to be successful, it must be able to move from point A to point B, carry a cup in here, and be controlled by the user, which should be accomplished through all of these systems working together.
Okay, for critical path and critical features, one of our main concerns is a volume feature, and that primarily focuses on the tracking. We're going to be using the Bluetooth, but if that doesn't work out, you wonder like what we would switch to, and you know, we go on the camera or the designs, some things different. And along with that is the autonomous capability. So if the device can move by itself and let itself run into obstacles like rocks or trees or something like that. And the other side of that is the functionality of the car, which is the game for the setup. If we can get the gearbox to work correctly, and if the device can hold the correct amount of load that we're aiming for, along with the alteration capabilities, so if we don't want it to just be like in the city or in the services, like be able to work on or pretty much just from all the terrain. And so that brings us to our critical features, which is move, so just if the device can move forward, backwards, left, right, and just get from point A to point B. And along with that is carry, so if the device can move while holding whatever they do want, like equipment or other materials. And finally, hand control, so the device moving as the user would want.
We'll be observing using a
you can select the code we want to use, and then you can figure out what gear ratio we want in the gearbox to most efficiently transfer the power to the gram. Once we have our mass distribution analyzed, we're working on analyzing the suspension and coming up with the design of the suspension, controlling the maximum force to the item for the max weight, and controlling the suspension system that the vessel is going. And our power consumption is also a key component that we are going to have to find. We can get a rough estimate of our power consumption once we have our oil picked out, as that's going to be the main, that's going to draw the most power out of all of our electrical systems.
From the Raspberry Pi that we have on the RC fire, we're going to test it off this monster.